Well, Kamish is on the stage. The anticipation is ripe. The building is raucous. We're ready to get this thing underway. Hey, hey, you don't say that. And with the first pick of the 2018 Mock It Up Before You Fock It Up, Big Co drafting for the Easton Assassins selects Saquon Barkley.
Had to. Easy pick. Couldn't wait for it.
Doesn't even matter who you're drafting for.
I can touch on some of this guy's team.
He passed us the draft card right when he walked in.
The draft card was made out, laminated weeks in advance. Saquon Barkley, don't get too cute. We said that weeks ago on the podcast here. This dude's got Zeke on his team. He's got Joe Mixon on his team. Not much for receiver. Got pretty heavy on the tight ends. Got a solid quarterback if Andrew Luck gets back to throwing weighted footballs again.
Well, he's got Andy Dalton.
Exactly. He's got insurance.
Well, I thought that's where you were going when you said he had a solid quarterback.
This is a one QB league.
He's got a potential Hall of Famer in Andrew Luck if he can ever get back on the football field. But again, it has nothing to do. If you're stacked at running back and you're sitting at the 1-1, you take Saquon and you become even more stacked at running back.
Right.
You can never be too stacked at running back.
Absolutely not.
That ship sails quickly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Real quick. Yeah. Things can happen quickly with your injuries. If you think you have three good running backs and you can only start two, don't get weighted down on the bench there and ship one off for no reason. Just hang out and just ride it. If you're good at running back, you're going to be in the playoffs.
Most likely. I mean, if you can build any semblance of a team around
running backs win championships in fantasy
football. Get some catches. You know, I've been in plenty of situations where you left one season at the end of a season coming into another season where you think, you know, your running back core is set and you got some picks and you drafted a running back and then you get into the season and all of a sudden by week three, you're, you know, scrounging around for a second running back to start.
Yeah, it happens quickly.
An ACL there, a hammy here.
And just, you know, somebody for
a
whatever
suspension
reason.
Over there.
Yeah, just
a little
all
puff,
sorts
puff
of things.
Here.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
A little PED, you never know. You can't be too stacked. I hate when I hear people say, oh, well, I'm really good at running back, so I need a wide receiver. Like, maybe you should just get a running back. Like,
well, I mean, I can see it when you get a little later in the process here, but especially with Saquon Barkley and the prospect that is.
Right. There's a solid prospect.
Right.
Solid player on the board. You got to take that running
back. You got to pull the trigger. And then the Giants go ahead and back up their, you know, second pick, which some people are upset that you take Saquon with the first pick. You know, we'll have a whole show about, or at least this long segment of a show about
why
it's ridiculous or not ridiculous to draft a running back in the top five or however, whatever number you want to go with, first round, whatever.
Yeah.
Not an argument for
today's show.
For today's show, but so they draft Will Hernandez with their second pick, who's
34th overall.
He's a mauler.
Could have easily gone mid to late first round.
Sure, he was the second best guard on the board. A lot of people were saying outside of Quentin Nelson,
mauler in the run game, like you
mauler
were saying.
In the run game. Good. Great pick for Saquon. Hopefully he pans out. It's an offensive lineman, just like
great
any other prospect
Giants.
In the draft. You never know if they're actually going to pan out. An offensive lineman are one of those ones that you don't really know, but he's a big dude, and he's stout in the run game.
Right, and it's a huge area of need for the Giants. The Giants didn't have good run blocking or pass blocking last year. So
graded out as the 26th best line per PFF.
Which there ain't a whole lot more teams than 26, so they're at the back.
180 pressures.
Yeah, and so and then Saquon pick. You got the generational talent running back, and, you know, I did see a tweet where some guy goes, can you have a generational talent come out every year?
Yeah.
And you know what? Maybe. We've had him for a couple of years in a row, and I got no problem with it, so I'm not going to hold that.
Well, Leonard Fournette wasn't generational.
I'm not going to hold that against Saquon Barkley. So that he helps Eli. He helps the wide receivers. He helps the defense. He helps the O-line. I think he'll help the Giants win some games.
And the Giants helped their own O-line. They went and
pre-agency,
Nate
did their due diligence
from the Patriots.
Diligence,
and yeah,
they,
it was a huge pickup.
Then they went right back and drafted a hopefully good
left guard,
plug and play starter at either left guard or right guard. They picked up Patrick. I struggle with this one.
The offensive lineman last names are
yeah.
the toughest.
They are the toughest.
Omame.
That's
Patrick
a decent,
Omame.
Decent shot.
So that's the best I got. I'm not sure how to pronounce his name. He's
don't
from,
add him.
He's from the Jaguars. He's played some left guard, but he started his career playing right guard. So he can. The Giants said they're not sure where they're going to plug Hernandez in yet. They should probably just pick a side of the line that Solder's on and put Hernandez next to him and just get one solid side.
Right.
They tendered Brett Jones as center.
Vikings used to do a couple years ago. They'd run behind that left tackle, left guard all day long.
But the right side of this line could be a little dicey. We'll see what happens there.
Eric Flowers may or may not play.
Well, if they're a little dicey, that's way better than last year.
Right. Well,
last year they were a lot dicey.
And you know, one of the best players in the league, whether you like him or not, Odell missed a good portion of the season.
Sure. Right. And you can't key in on Saquon.
Right.
You can't just pick him to stop. You got to stop Odell, given that they keep him, which it looks like that's happening.
Right.
And Saquon's no stranger to a bad offensive line either.
Right. Last year you knew the Giants couldn't effectively really run it at you too much, and you weren't really worried about too many weapons around you. You had Evan Ingram, who was a rookie who played well, but still a rookie tight end, and you had Sterling Shepard who played great as well. I like Sterling Shepard as much as the next guy, but then they had a bunch of Jamokes playing every other wide receiver position possible.
No doubt, especially when Odell went down. So,
right, that's what I'm saying.
Right. So, but you bring back, you get Odell back, and the Giants did a good job not trading him away. So you got Odell. You got the.
He is saying he might sit right now, but off-season semantics here. We'll see what happens.
I can't blame him to sit until I get paid either. Especially after that injury. But so you got your second year tight end who obviously proved himself as a playmaker last year. And then you got Sterling Shepard, and now you bring in Saquon. So you have weapons. You have ways to stretch the defense out. So things get easier for Eli. And I'm not going to sit here and take up for Eli. And you have somebody else say that his worst season always followed by his best season, and that's happened like 4 or 5 years in a row. So expect him to break back out. I don't expect Eli Manning to break back out.
I don't think the Giants need him to.
I expect him to definitely level out.
Right.
And because with all those weapons, things get so much easier, and they all work together. It'll be a lot. Everything they do
just
on offense
balance
this
out
year,
a little more.
Exactly. I was about to say they're just all those pieces, when you put them together and you let them complement each other. Saquon's awesome already. Odell's awesome already. You know,
he spent all this money on the defense 2 years ago, and then it panned out for you, and then it was kind of fell apart a little bit last year.
Yeah,
because guess what? Yeah, they didn't want to play over there. Your offense can hardly do anything.
They played at home, but they didn't play on the road.
Your run game, your run game was, you didn't even try half the time.
Sure,
you didn't stick with it. So now, you know, you got a guy who you can rely on, you can hand it to or throw it to however many times you want a game. You can lean on this guy, and then you know, like Jay Wayne said at the beginning of the kickoff here with Saquon, it's gonna be really tough. You got to pick somebody to stop or just kind of spread out.
If you middle ground it, I just think I'm excited for the Giants. I mean, I'm not necessarily just pulling for them each and every week, but I'm excited for the Giants, and I hope with all the hate that got thrown out
there.
Shurmur. Yeah, I hope that they come out and do well, and that Saquon does awesome. I really do. I hope that it, you know, proves that some naysayers wrong with the whole early pick thing.
Yeah, now that smug face, what was the old coach? Smuggest face in the
The offensive coordinator turned coach?
Yeah. I can't even remember his name.
This is how forgettable
he was. That's how bad
he was.
Just forget about it.
Oh, good deal. Well, we could continue talking about the Giants and the situation and the draft pick, but for this discussion, it doesn't even matter because it didn't matter where Saquon was going. He's number one pre-draft, number one post-draft for your rookie draft anyway. And I mean, that's just
how it is. He's going to help your team immediately and be super – like, this is what you hope for when you're the 1-1 coming around, of how quickly your team could be turned around just from this draft pick.
Captain Obvious, you're not taking Saquon. You're not taking him. If you don't take him, you're an idiot.
You dumb up.
The only thing that you could do is potentially trade him, the opportunity for somebody to trade that you could trade him, but you can't make another pick.
Right.
You can trade the 1-1 for basically anything you want.
Better get a lot.
You can get anything you want for the 1-1, like comparable. Somebody might give you Zeke, somebody might give you Bell, somebody might give you David Johnson, or very, very close to that. But you cannot not take Saquon. You either take him or trade that pick for somebody else's best player, the sure stud.
And it's just, you know, take another second here. And it's just like a guy like Ezekiel Elliott, when he came in, will turn the course of your franchise around and take you from being the worst team to, if you can, like we led the top of the broadcast off with, if you can put any semblance of any sort of team around him, you can, you will get to the playoffs and hope maybe even win the championship. It happened in this league.
Yep.
The guy got Zeke. Kenny Britt played well for him, and he had Jordy Nelson playing well for him, and he had Le'Veon Bell coming off the season before that, and got those two guys together, and has an awful team now. Still has an awful team. Yeah. He traded Ezekiel Elliott away later, but he still got to the championship.
2 years ago, when he had Zeke first overall, it took him to a championship.
So yeah.
If you could find your way into having two stud backs on a team, and you can find wide receivers that will catch the ball, you'll be fine.
Saquon's who you're looking for at 1-1. I mean, just in any draft.
Good to go.
All right.